Today we will be doing one of these videos I've seen across YouTube that I kind of like. Those like what happens if you put a foreign disc in your whatever? Okay, so I figured I'd do my own. So today we'll be doing what happens if you put a foreign disc in your Blu-ray player. Right here I have my Samsung BD-J5700 Blu-ray player. No, I don't know if there's anything special about this. Anyways, let's get to the discs I will be testing with this thing. Just to show you that this player actually works, I'll be testing a Blu-ray, the Lego Movie, and I will be testing a DVD, Cats 101, since Blu-ray players can also play DVDs, as we all know. Next off, I'll be testing Super Mario Bros. Wii plus Super Mario Bros. U plus Super Luigi U for the Wii U. See if I can play some Wii U games on this thing. Because we're all hoping for that forwards compatibility. Next off, I'll be testing Mario Kart Wii for the Wii. Again, hoping for the forwards compatibility. Next off, I'll be testing a CD. This is Hizbop 32. And if this thing does play, I'll probably turn the volume down or try and talk over it because I don't want to get copyrighted. Anyways, let's move on to the next disc. Next off, I'll be testing this CD for, like, I think our cable system that you, like, put in your computer to get instructions. And next off, we have New Super Mario Bros. 2 for the 3DS. Next off, we have Mario Kart DS for the DS. Next off, we have Baby Einstein Neighborhood Animals VHS. Well, I think you guys recognize this tape if you've seen my video where I reviewed this thing. And I'm glad I didn't get copyrighted for showing this thing. I'm glad YouTube understood me and knew that I wasn't trying to pirate this thing. That I was just trying to review it. Anyways. Next off, I'll be testing a cassette. Getting started with your electronic keyboard. Now let's get started with this. Let's get the Blu-ray out. First, let's open the disc tray. Now we're going to get the Blu-ray out and just show you that it works. My camera's kind of pointing this angle so you can see both the Blu-ray player and the TV screen. Now let's go. There we go, it's making its normal noises like it does. That was just the end credits. So at least we know it works, but that was just the end credits because I normally stop the movie at the end credits. And what I know about this player is, just like VHS, if you were watching a certain part of the movie and you have to go do something else, and you can just pause the movie, and this player will know exactly where you were. That's pretty interesting. Now let's go get the DVD. I hope the music in that part wasn't copyright. I don't think it was, because I don't second of it. Anyways, let's get the DVD. Now, let's get the DVD out. Here we go. So as you know, this player does make some pretty loud whirring noises when it's reading the disc. There we go. It works. Now we know this player works because I tested a Blu-ray and a DVD in it. Now it's time to go. Now it's time to get the CD right here, but I'm gonna turn the volume down on my TV. That's pretty good, so I won't get copyright. Now, let's get this thing out. This is a Blu-ray player, so likely it won't play CDs, likely it will. It's a 50-50 chance. Anyways, let's go. Let's see what this thing does. It does play CDs. So, now I know this player can play CDs, as well as DVDs and Blu-rays. And, yeah, I'm glad I turned the volume down just in case if this thing played. Now, I better turn the volume back up a little bit. Time for this CD, which you can put in your computer. Let me see if computer discs work on Blu-ray players. Yep, there we go. Now, let's close it. Come on, loading CD. It's reading it as a CD. Photos, videos, music. What are photos? Wow! So this thing actually does read data CDs like this. What are videos? Oh, it actually does read that. Turn the volume pretty low again because there's a part. The part that says music. I don't know if it's audible or not. Meaning it has voice or it has music. Let's see. I'm sure this is like audible now. Yeah. So I know this thing can read data CDs. Anyways, time to move on to the next disc. Now we have Super Mario Bros. U plus Super Luigi U for the Wii U. Yep, two games on one disc. Cannot load this disc. Please. please check the disc. Oh, this thing didn't even try to read it. Maybe it tried to, but I don't know what format this is. Are Wii U discs CDs, DVDs, or Blu-rays, or some other unknown disc format? Just that this thing can't read it. It didn't even try and read any of the files on it. Ah, ridiculous. I was hoping I was going to be able to play Wii U on this Blu-ray player. Anyways, moving on. Right here, we have Mario Kart Wii for the Wii. Let's put it in. I hope Wii has better luck than Wii U because it was a better selling console. Loading. Darn loading screens. I know. I hear it making a weird noise. You hear that? It's struggling trying to read this disc. I hope it doesn't eat my disc. Loading. Come on, it's been sitting here for quite a while. I think this one's a no-go. Okay. So the Wii disc was a no-go. Next off, we are going to try the VHS. And the only way to get it to stay on here is just use a little sticky tape like this. So let me get my sticky tape out. Right here. Come on. We always hope for backwards compatibility. There we go. Fits on the disc tray perfectly. Now let's close it. Alrighty. So this one's a no-go. Like you probably knew that. Next off, we're going to try the cassette. Getting started with your electronic keyboard. Wow, will this one actually fit? I hope it doesn't get stuck. It's stuck. You see that? It got stuck for a little bit. Then the disc tray eventually flung open again, realizing something was jamming it, and it just flung it off right there, just like that. Anyways, time to try the next thing. Next off, we have New Super Mario Bros. 2 for the 3DS. Let's open up this little port right here and hopefully it'll fit. Let's hope for something not fitting in there. Let's try opening this again. Will this thing get stuck in here? I better tape it down so it doesn't get stuck. Will it just tray even close with this thing on? There we go. That's how you do it. And nothing. Oh man. I was hoping I was going to be able to play 3DS on this thing. There we go. At least my cartridge didn't get stuck in there. Next off, we have Mario Kart DS for the DS. We always hope for that. We always hope for that forwards compatibility. There we go. Now let's no disc. Ah man, this always forwards compatibility, but we have one more item to try. Yep, we have one more. Our last item is going to be, voila, a $20 bill. Yeah, I want to buy a Blu-ray using this machine. Hopefully that'll work. Let's put the dollar bill in here. Wait, let me just get the wrinkles off of it first. This and stick it in here. Well, it may actually work. Let me try that again. Let me go ahead and try and flatten it out a little more and try that again. Look, I won't even take it. Come on, take my money. Give me a Blu-ray. Give me my money. This time it actually took it. You can still kind of see it in there. Let's get this thing out. Dear God, it's stuck. I may need to fish it out using something. So, that'll conclude today's video. I'm gonna stop the camera right now so I can get that dollar bill out of this machine. Because apparently I got it stuck in there. Anyways, see you next time. Comment, like, and subscribe for more videos like this.